that we are live. I'm just gonna, post this on... Yep.
Oh, wait, sorry, sideways. Someone's at the door. I need to go away for, like, 5 hours.
Type, you are not funny.
Neither are you.
Total War Warhammer. Live now.
Citizen.
It'd be an amazing Let's Player, wouldn't it?
Go home and play again, citizen.
Video game to your friend, citizen. Video game to your friend. Why won't you be our friend, citizen?
Video game to the glorious capitalist government, citizen.
Okay, well, I think we should just sit around not doing anything for a while before we start. Are you those and you haven't watching the VOD? I'll explain all this, by the way, or rather the lack of all this, in a couple of... I'll explain what all this, what's happened here.
I'm sorry, Sideways, I just noticed something.
What, is it that my room is fucking empty?
No, the shirt you're wearing. I had no idea you were a Flash fan.
I am not. I don't know how I got this.
What would make that perfect is if you put on your Jedi bathrobe.
I don't like Marvel. I don't like Star Wars. Fum, fum, fum.
What else do you not like, Sideways?
Sorry, just a moment.
Ah, good. Cyburger's here. We can put him on the grill.
Sorry, someone just sent me a message on Facebook, and I need to tell them to go away. Ah, dear. Right, let's wait until some more people come in. Type, you got anything you want to talk about while we're waiting?
So yeah, you were talking about that growth you had on your shoulder, and I think I know what it is and how to fix it.
It's a face, not a growth. No, really, Ty, have you got anything you want to talk about?
Well, it's your live stream. I was hoping that you would take the lead.
Well, I will when the game's started, but, like...
We got
10 minutes.
So, Sideways, I have a question for you.
What?
What is your favorite way to prepare eggs?
I don't like eggs.
Toast?
Sorry, is that the same question but replacing eggs with toast?
Yes.
Are you asking me if I toast eggs? Because I know I don't cook, type. I know that you. I know that you have a very low opinion of my understanding of how food is made. But I know that you don't toast eggs. Believe it or not, in my lifetime, there are few things that I have ever
actually,
been served
that's
on.
Not entirely true. There is a special novelty kit where you can put eggs inside of a special bread-shaped tin that's air and liquid tight. You put it in the toaster, and it toasts the eggs to make the shape of a slice of toast.
Sorry, I got bored and started doing the Evil Dead camera thing.
You know what I mean? I just imagine those are the noises that you make when you're making.
Okay.
Actually, It sounds like you're having a bowel movement.
Fuck. Okay, what the fuck is wrong with your digestive system? That's what you think a bowel movement sounds like.
No. That's what I think your bowel movement sounds like.
Oh, yeah, because of my diet of, like, meat, and yet further meat, occasionally garnished with meat, soaked in meat with a side of meat.
Yes.
All of it chased down with a lovely frothing cup of yet further meat. It's just like...
Are you the type of person who drinks gravy?
No.
You sure?
Who the fuck drinks gravy?
Fat people.
You're an asshole, Ty.
Sorry.
You're saying something about my weight, type.
No, no.
Yes. Yes, you are. No. Stream's over!
And that's all I wanted all along.
I'm gonna kick you to death. I mean,
but wait, sideways, you only eat meat? What about small fruit?
Small fruit is an object of worship.
You do not eat your objects of worship. No. Would you eat Jesus, Muhammad, or Moses? I think not.
I would, yes, but that's because they're made of meat. That's going to be the day that you genuinely despise me. The second coming of Christ occurs. You rush to the
Oh boy! You're putting on a bib and holding out your fork and knife and running to the front of the line.
No, you rush to the scene to, you know, see your Lord and Savior. And you just get to, like, the auditorium or wherever the fuck he's shown up. And there's just, like, thousands of people horrified. Because there's just me with Christ strapped on, like, ah! Please, God, help me! Just sitting there like, oh.
Okay, stop making snorting noises. That's just weird. You know what? When you make snorting noises, put your nose up so it looks like a pig snout.
You'll see that in a couple of seconds, type.
I don't really want to.
Too bad. You requested it, so it's happening. Oh, dear.
What
does okay.
Tony Abbott taste like? Agnerdeen? What do you think you taste like, sideways?
Sorry, I have been, like, shouting like that for even a short time. It's not doing my throat hurt any good. Not in the slightest. You know why I hate this shirt? Because I don't really care that it's got the flash in it. It's a pajama shirt. You know what I mean? But yeah, yeah. There's a reason that I actually hate this shirt.
Why?
Because you can see my fucking birthmark.
Ooh, show.
No.
Because... Oh, is that spot on your arm?
That's, yeah, this the brown thing is a birthmark. And, like, whenever anyone...
I've seen it before, and I thought that was just like a giant cancerous mole.
Yeah, no, people always say that shit, no? I used to get questioned about it a lot. It's one of the reasons, I'm pretty sure, why I constantly wear jackets. It's weird, it's just got, like, really long black hair on it.
Okay, put it away, please.
I can't.
I know a few good surgeons that you might be willing to talk to.
I forget that's there sometimes.
Why don't you give it a close-up at the camera sideways? Let the audience
I just
experience.
Did, actually.
Oh.
Like, as you were saying that, I was that, like, before you said that, I actually leaned in. Right, what time are we on?
Well, at least it's not on your face.
Yeah, that is a thing. Like, at the very least, I could just, like, cover that shit up. And no one has to look at it. Anyway.
I actually think there's a button. If you push down on it, you'll probably self-destruct. By the way, this is what entertainment with the two of us consists of. We just make noises at each other and laugh at ourselves like we're the hottest shit.
Well, we do keep getting webbies.
Well, yeah, I'm actually starting to run out of places to put them.
Yeah, I mean, you think that's a dog? It's not. It's a living webby. They're just condensed.
Your entire house is made out of webbies.
That's why I got rid of all this shit. There's a truck of webbies outside. I can't have other possessions. The webbies are slowly taking over my home. Eventually, the atoms in this part of the country are going to be shaped like tiny webbies. Oh, dear. Okay, right, fuck it. Okay, good, we're at half an hour. We're at 9:30, so now I can do the introduction. Hello?
Greetings!
That was a very kid's show. Like, hello and welcome.
I don't like the tone that those kid's show hosts put on.
Why?
It's a mixture of patronizing and I hate you.
Hey, both of us.
Hello? You children have made it so I can't be taken seriously as a television personality. I'm going to be doing this till they stick me in my grave. Hello? Actually, no. I'm only going to be doing this for a few more years because, well, you can't very well have a middle-aged children's show host, can you?
No, because then they'll call you a pedophile. Okay. So, right. Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and with me here today is...
A person who's been roped into this against his will.
I fucking just asked if you fancied joining me and you said yes, so shut up.
Well, what the hell was I supposed to say? No, I don't feel like it. Maybe another time?
Yes.
Fuck you.
But yes, I'm just here with a bit of an old Imperius Impressions, I suppose. Really? Of Total Warhammer. Or Total War Warhammer on that there PC. I pre-ordered it, got it today. Been playing it all day, been really enjoying it. Been playing the Orc campaign, been playing some of the Imperial campaign. And I just figured, since like it came out on the day that I stream, and I haven't been streaming much lately, I might as well, you know, put it on screen. You know what I mean? Play a bit of it. And, you know, maybe play Chaos, because, you know, the two factions I'm most interested in are the Forces of Chaos and the Orcs. And I haven't played Chaos. I've deliberately put off playing the Chaos campaign. Until this year's stream. Now I am going to say something. Those of you who are familiar with my streams, or my VODs, will, as I believe I mentioned earlier, be wondering where everything is. Because normally I've got, like, bookcases full of thousands of pounds worth of books, DVDs, and video games over there. For the first time in...
You thought they were made of meat and you ate them all.
Yes, this is factual. however, in the real world... For the first time since I've moved in into this house, which I moved in when I was like 11, I have allowed my brother to redecorate my room, and he's to just use it as an excuse to steal everything.
It's all in his room now. He sleeps on it like a
dragon with gold. He grew a tail and everything, just to complete the metaphor, just like... No.
Every morning when you leave your room, it's like that scene in The Hobbit with Smaug.
Yeah. My brother's redecorating my room, so all my stuff's actually just in that cupboard. He's, like, redecorating, I'm getting a new chair, he's, like, painting it black and red, because I'm just the edgiest motherfucker in town. My brother's really into like DIY and redecoration, and he's fairly good at it. So I'm gonna have like this whole fucking like thing, like this whole like unit built all over the place with like custom built desk and all this shit. And it's gonna be pretty cool when it's finished. But that's why my stuff's gone, it's because my room's getting redecorated. Right, so we're just gonna play. We're just gonna go into some Total War Warhammer here. I'm gonna go to new campaign. I am playing this slightly modded, because, it won't come into...
The mods all ready for it?
Yeah, there were mods set up before it came out. There were set up... They basically just addressed two of the complaints people have for this game. One of them being... The one that I'm using right now is the fact that for some bizarre reason you can't have regional occupation... Like only certain races can take over other certain races' stuff. Like, humans in the base game can only take over other human settlements and vampire settlements, and nothing else. So they can't take over, like, Norskan settlements, and they can't take over Orc settlements or Dwarf settlements. And similarly, the Orcs can only take Dwarf settlements, and vampires can only take human settlements. It's weird. The mod I have basically just lets everyone take everything except for Chaos, because Chaos doesn't have cities. At all. They just burn shit down. Because they're Chaos. They're basically this huge roaming band of fucking lunatics.
That, like, demon Atar thing, that looks so similar to the types of demons they have in Warcraft.
Well, yes. Like, I believe we've mentioned this before, haven't we?
Yes, but it's one thing to talk about it, and another thing, it's jarring to actually see it in practice.
That's fair. Okay, so we've got three possible generals to serve as our main general and our leader of sorts.
What's wrong with the skin?
Who's?
Oh wait, no, that's his helmet.
Yeah, Archeron, the Ever Chosen, who is the strongest thing ever, and he's the champion of all the Chaos Gods. He's option one. Then we have Kollek Sun Eater, who is a ancient dragon ogre, big horrible monstrous bastard. We could use him.
Play as Blondie.
And yes, we have Prince Sigvald the Magnificent.
Blondie. Blondie.
I don't want to be the blonde guy type.
Yes, be Blondie.
I don't want to be the blonde guy type.
But you can be so flamboyant while committing your evil atrocities.
But he's gonna look weird type.
I know, it'll be funny. Play as Blondie, come on.
Kollek is like fucking 20 feet tall.
Yeah, but Blondie, McBlonderson, who's a little poncy shit.
Fine, I'll play as the blonde guy.
Yes!
You fucking asshole. It's not watch the fucking cutscene. Weirdly, every single cutscene is introduced by the same guy. Like, your advisor, no matter which faction you're playing as, is always the same guy.
Oh, that's a bit disappointing.
I want to know who the fuck he is.
It would be funny if they just had the guy for Total War Shogun doing the voice. All the hail the chaos!
Our orcs are running from the battlefield! A shame for this brain! I need to stop shouting, my throat is genuinely... I'm going to start bleeding from the throat if I keep doing this. Oh, dear. Right, I like chaos. Just in general. No, I like the Chaos faction. I think Chaos is kind of interesting. Although, Chaos is kind of weird in Warhammer Fantasy, I believe. Because I'm used to Chaos in Warhammer 40k.
Your adopted father calls you, Sigvald.
Shut up. Yeah, this guy. This advisor douchebag up here. He's the advisor for everyone. He's kind of weird. You know, I'm gonna put him as Minute Mole, because I don't like the advisor chiming in every couple of fucking minutes to be like, "Hey, dickhead, do this!" Like, I'm not about that, so...
Oh, you actually control, a specific character?
Well, you control several, but, like, when you pick your leader, that's, like, your legendary general at the beginning of the game, and it's functionally your main character. I mean, there is, like, another dude who's actually in charge of Chaos, but this guy is functionally in charge of Chaos, if you pick him. Right, well... Really...
I'm sure he'll be a great leader.
You're an asshole. Let's have a look at his stats, shall we? He's a duelist, he's got charge defense against everything, he's a melee expert, and he's armored and shielded. And what does our army actually consist of? We've got a bunch of Chaos Chosen with Halberds, a bunch of normal Chaos Chosen, a couple of Chaos Warriors, a couple of Chaos Marauders, a couple of Chaos Marauder Horsemen, a couple of Ugly Dogs, and Chaos Spawn, and a cannon. We have a Chaos Hell Cannon, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a Chaos Hell Cannon. I'm happy now.
Really? I don't believe you.
I like Chaos Hell Cannons.
No, I don't believe that you're happy.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. I'm happy because I like Chaos Hell Cannons. Weirdly, even though Chaos has only got the goal of destroying everything, they have a diplomacy screen.
It's weird, the orcs also have that too, you told me.
Yeah, like, but... With the orcs, you can kind of see it, because, like, in the lore... I don't know in the lore of fantasy, but I assume in fantasy... You do get occasions when people make deals with orcs. Chaos has been known to make deals with orcs. And I think, like, this... I think even the Inquisition, in some cases, in Warhammer 40k, have been known to make deals with orcs as well. Okay, we researched a thing. Fine, let's get Scrutiny of the Dark Gods. Okay, we're going to go to our first fight. We're going to burn down this camp. Even though, from the looks of it, they worship Chaos as well. But you know what? Fuck them. Yeah, these guys are all clearly Chaos worshippers. But as I say, fuck them.
They don't worship chaos in the way you specifically want them to, so you must make them bleed for their misconceptions.
It's the George Carlin thing. My god has got a bigger dick than your god. Like, do you believe in God? No. Dead. Do you believe in God? Yes. Do you believe in my god? No. Dead. My god has a bigger dick than your god.
Do you believe in God? Yes. Do you believe in my God? Yes. Do you believe in him the same way that I do? No.
Dead. My God has got a slightly further to the left dick than your God.
Oh, shit.
What if your God is the God of dicks?
What if your God is the God of tits and wine?
Wait, are we talking about Greek mythology here?
No, it's a quote from Game of Thrones.
Or Japanese mythology.
The God of Tits and Wine is a quote from Game of Thrones. Tyrion Lannister gets drunk as a mule on his wedding day, and for some bizarre reason he just says to his father, "I'm the God of Tits and Wine."
Goodness, what a boy he has sired.
Okay, so here we are in the frozen fucking shithole of Nausicaa. Literally standing on a pile of ice and snow. Makes you
look
wonder.
At these people. They've wronged you in no way, and they're living a happy, fulfilling lives. You should take care of that.
Makes you wonder why the Norskans dress like this, doesn't it? Like, it's the coldest part of the world, and they wear the least clothing of anyone, except maybe the orcs.
Maybe they're just immune to it, like the Nords are.
Okay. So, we're gonna put Prince fucking pretty boy. Oh, he's got a mirror shield. Ugh.
Is the mirror on the outside or the inside?
Oh, the outside. He'd get distracted if it was on the inside. No, seriously, in the fluff, this guy has a bunch of guards, or bodyguards, who basically just carry mirrors for him. So he can look at himself whenever he wants.
It's kind of weird that they have a pretty boy in the service of chaos, the, like, group of people who, like, don't they glorify being hideous and spiky?
Depends who they worship. He's a, Sigvald is a worshipper of, the god of, pleasure and excess.
Ah.
Okay, so we got a lovely little front line here.
Hey, Sideways, this is all very interesting. I'm gonna go get a drink. I'll be right back.
Okay, good for you. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, you get to see the most interesting part of watching anyone play the Total War games. Watching them set up their formation.
I don't know why you're having sarcasm. I mean, I'm fucking riveted.
Thought you were going to get a drink.
Exactly.
Go get a fucking drink, asshole. I don't know why I put up with that, man. I really don't.
You know you like it.
Shut up, type. Okay. Put some angry dogs who, from the looks of it, don't have any handler. I mean, I get it. They're twisted chaos freaks, but if anything, that would, to my mind, that would mean they needed a handler even more. Then again, I suppose that would look a bit weird. But if in, like, Rome, yeah, like the Rome game, they had, the dogs you could unlock as the Rome faction had handlers. Though they were slightly weird. Because you, like, used them once, and then they were useless for the rest of the game. Okay. Will bring us to glory. What are they actually armed with? Is it just spears? I suppose they are missile cavalry, so presumably they're fighting with javelins. Right. Now I suppose we wait for them to come to us. That is assuming they are actually going to move. In the Total War games, a lot of the time if you attack them, the enemy just stays there. Yep, they're just staying there, right. Let's just keep these guys up here so we can flank with them. What I really want is I want to be able to set up my cannon so I can fire at them from a distance. Because that would be quite funny. Hang on a minute. The cannon breaks loose of its... Is that... Oh, I was hoping that was gonna... have a cool visual, but no. That's deeply, deeply disappointing. Oh god, they're moving. They started moving when I wasn't looking. Shit. Fire at them. Actually, no. No, hell cannon. Please don't fire at them. What's happening? You guys get involved there. I don't know what to do with the rest of them. I don't know. Fuck it. Fuck it. Charge. Who cares? We vastly outnumber them. We've got the power of the Dark Gods is on our side. Fuck them. Who cares? To battle. I mean, this is fine, right? This is fine. We're not all gonna die because of this, right? Right? I mean, we seem to be relatively okay in attempting to just completely fucking surround them. Although that... it's a bit silly that there's just dogs running around desperately trying to chase these fuckers down. Oh god, the cannon's firing. No, stop firing, for the love of god, you're firing into my men. Wait, hang on a minute, fuck me! Sigvald is like... Up, yep, and here come the Chaos Spawn. Just the horrible, pulsating, pustulent meat sacks. There's something really deeply unpleasant about watching these things attack people. Like, just everything about how they move is horrible. Now, how the fuck am I supposed to deal with this cavalry?
I'm back.
Hi, I'm winning.
Good. And, I have good news, too. My gourmet homebrewed iced tea came out perfectly, as usual.
You do realize you're becoming a parody of yourself, right?
I thought I was that since the day we actually started talking.
No, no, possibly. I've been caught in a really fucking awkward situation. I'm chasing fucking horses round in a constant circle because I've got nothing that can catch up to them.
Archers?
How fast do you think archers are?
Well, ranged. Look, just like tie a bunch of dynamite to a goblin and throw it at them.
Okay, I'm playing Chaos.
Well, it doesn't mean you don't have, like, it doesn't mean you can't use goblins.
Yes, it does.
Conscription.
You can't. From where? Goblins don't live in this part of the old world.
Well, they're fungus. They probably sprout out of the ground if you start
digging. Well, you know what? That is a lie. Some. Goblins do live in this part of the old world, just not much.
Oh.
Okay, we got the walking tumors still moving around.
Well, if you have them move around enough, they might just shave some of the weight off.
And I ask you, what are these, if not walking tumors? Oh, good, the enemy horseman just charged my fucking chaos spawn.
I like how they have crab claws.
They're really grim, conceptually, those things.
Ugh, I don't like looking at them too long.
Do you know what they are?
What?
The chaos spawn are literally chaos chosen, but who mutated too much. And it became uncontrollable, so they turned into, horrible, pulsating, pustulant freaks.
Lovely.
Welcome to working for the forces of chaos. We have a good medical plan, you'll just turn into a fucking freak!
Well, I wouldn't mind joining for the dental.
It's kind of a medieval high renaissance time period. What the fuck kind of dental plan do you think they have? You ask about the dental plan, they point you to a fucking pair of pliers in the corner. Next to a bloody rag.
Yeah, well, it's better than nothing.
It's better than the American healthcare system. Was topical like 6 years ago.
Fuck you, Obamacare. You ruined a good joke.
Wait, Obamacare ruined the joke that was the American medical system? Is that what you're saying?
Depends on who you ask.
I'm asking you.
Well, I get free healthcare anyway, so it's fine.
Okay, question. Do I just burn some stuff and take what I can from this place? Destroy it entirely? Or, force it to be my slave?
Force it to be your slave?
No, I'm burning it to the ground.
Okay. I would have gone for a long-term plan, but sure.
Well, no, I think the ultimate goal of Chaos is to burn everything to the ground.
Well, you can do that, just don't tell them until it happens.
Hi, we all work together. By the way, would you mind just playing real...
Chaos is your friend, citizen. Don't mind the fire, citizen.
Chaos is your friend, embrace the flame.
Have you heard the word of chaos, citizen?
What? Fire will only burn you if you don't accept the word of chaos, citizen.
If you feel pain as the fire consumes you, that means you just don't believe hard enough, citizen.
You can dance if you want to, citizen.
No one will judge you, citizen. We're all brothers and sisters in arms here, citizen.
You can leave your friends behind. If your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, then they're being non-compliant, citizen.
We're being non-compliant, we'll be captured and re-educated.
They're being non-compliant, they will die. As will you, if you remain non-compliant.
You can dance if you want to! You can leave your friends behind! If your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, then they get re-educated.
Copyright!
I don't think I'm gonna get copyright struck for that. You've been copyright struck! Bum, 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 copyright struck! Bum.
The day YouTube dies is the day that we all sing and dance and then eat each other because we have nothing left to do.
Sorry, Ty, I think what you just said to me made me go blind in one eye.
That was the plan. Why do you think I say these things? Specifically to cause you pain.
That makes sense. You are a relentlessly weird motherfucker.
It takes one to know one.
No, it really doesn't.
Yes, it does.
That's a really stupid phrase, frankly.
You're being non-compliant, citizen.
Fuck off, it's my joke!
Citizen, it has been confiscated, citizen. Stop being non-compliant.
You're non-compliant, so let your joke being confiscated and used for our personal use. Citizen.
Okay, I've got a choice.
I'll say that, citizen.
Okay, we've got a choice, Type.
What?
Burn down this place called Frozen Landing. And in so doing, have killed everyone in this province? Or murder...
Might as well.
Or go and attack the Kislevite army.
No. Burn that down. They have less chance to defend themselves. It's funny if they can't defend themselves.
They're enjoying their existences. They have to die. Also, my dog didn't just fight its way out of the room. My brother let him out.
Oh, I thought your dog was finally getting smart. Eventually, she's going to start running your YouTube channel for you.
Follower trait gained. Demagogue. Listen, brave men of the Empire, pray, but not to Sigmar. He cares not for us. There are other gods who are willing to answer your prayers. And we got some stat boosts. Okay. Oh, we got an item. Okay. The Chalice of Chaos. Gives the ability Demonic Strength, Dark Fortune, and Regenerating Flesh. Okay, let's take that. What the fuck is this? Okay, yeah, we got Demagogue. What's Enchanted Item? Does that just mean that these are just things I can do in battle now?
Yes. I'm an expert on this game, so you should ask me.
Yes, clearly. Also, I just realized he's got a trait called Supreme Vanity.
I like the sound of that.
I like the cut of his jib. I like the jib of his crotch.
His jib could cut diamonds. Wait, is it true that the only thing that can cut a diamond is another diamond?
Probably not. But I don't know why you'd think I'd know that.
Because you know things. You tell me you know things, so I ask you.
It's quite possibly the weirdest thing you've ever said.
I'm setting up little things with challenges for myself where I try and break that record every time consistently.
Yes, the thing is break the chain.
Sideways, that has got to be like the third least funny thing you ever said. And that's going to be the fourth.
Number one. Okay, what's that? Income from attacking settlements, yes, because the Chaos behave weirdly in this game, I've been told. Like, the only way to get anything done is basically just to keep attacking people. Like, you have to keep attacking people, otherwise your money just goes down the shitter.
What the hell are they spending it on? Poor investment plans?
Well, they don't actually get money, I believe. Yeah, their currency is called favor with the gods. So I suppose that the idea is that they're competing for the attention of their gods.
The fleeting, uncaring attention of their deities.
The fleeting, uncaring attention of the forces of chaos. It's almost sad, isn't it?
Why do they follow the Chaos Deities? If it's that fleeting and uncaring?
Numerous reasons. It really depends on who it is. Like, which individual you're asking about. Because a lot of them are just Norsican, and the Norsicans just historically have worshipped the Chaos Gods.
Yeah, well, what else are they gonna do?
I'm trying to think if there's ever any other... That Kislevite bastard!
What did he do?
He just rebuilt the city I blew up. I'm not fucking having that.
What a piece of shit!
What a sheesh of fit!
You know what? You want to know what that is?
What?
That's just not cricket. Sideways, you do realize that you're only encouraging me to do this.
Okay, I just got a thing. The Chaos Gods take notice of their champion, but rarely do they act in accord. Khorne demands slaughter, but Sneech orders a more subtle approach. Do we, go blood for the Blood God or the Changer's way?
Flip a coin. These types of decisions deserve to be treated flippantly.
Okay. I don't have a coin, but I do have a wallet. To make sure there's nothing important in this wallet.
I could flip it for you.
Nope. Okay. It came up cross, so I'm gonna say corn. I dropped my fucking house key.
There's a cross in your wallet?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've got the... Actually, Ty, when you see my wallet, you will just... Again, this is my wallet, because I'm the edgiest motherfucker in town. Oh, yeah.
Like, Edge City! Fucking Edge City!
The baddest motherfuckers you'll ever fight!
They don't even have a bedtime.
No, okay, no, we shouldn't be talking about this, because these people have no frame of reference for what the fuck we're talking about.
I know, that's why, that's... This is a good thing, it's funny to us, but they're just annoyed by it. Yep. Isn't that what it's...
That's how comedy.
Isn't that what these situations exist for? Entertainers exist only to entertain themselves at the expense of the audience. That's how it works, right?
No! I can't fight that guy.
You're not edgy enough.
I'm not.
Wipe them out!
I don't have enough edge type.
Crying shame.
Edge City, fucking Edge City, baddest motherfuckers you'll ever fight! Edge City, fucking Edge City, I can't remember the next line! Don't even have a bad time!
Attack!
Original song, Don't Steal.
Yeah, I'm just gonna draw a circle. And then
have you applied for the copyright yet?
I just did. Okay, now we're fighting Kislevitz.
Kislevitz.
Kislevitz. Although it does upset me that in this game Kislev isn't actually its own faction. It just uses the Empire assets and the Empire units. Because Kislev is part of the Empire, but I want... I just want... Kislev has fucking bear riders. Like, their cavalry is bears. And I want that. Bears.
I like that. I like that.
They're crazy, like, Russian motherfuckers. And they worship bears. Like, and their whole thing is they're basically, like, the only... They're, like, the thing that stands between the rest of the Empire and the madness that is Chaos. So they have to be badass motherfuckers. I'm imagining that they'll probably end up releasing DLC that turns Kislev from just kind of this generic faction to an actual faction.
We can only hope.
That or someone will mod it. But I don't know. There weren't actually that many like conversion mods for the there haven't been that many for the recent Total War games. You know what I mean?
Probably too difficult to mod.
Yeah, as games get higher and higher fidelity, they get harder and harder to mod.
Like, I wonder how hard the upcoming Bannerlord Mountain Blade game is going to be to mod for.
Probably won't be that hard.
Hmm.
You just need to change a couple of textures, really. Like, they all use the same character models. They just typically, they just tend to reapply textures and maybe make a new kind of shirt. You know what I mean?
And, like, new armor and weapons.
Yeah, but, like, not... But armor and weapons aren't difficult to model. You know what I mean?
I would have to take your word for it because I've never tried it before.
Compared to a person, they're not hard to model.
They're static items.
Yeah. Okay, so we've got yet further hideous chaos-ridden abominations in form of the poison chaos warhounds that are kind of green, glowing, and full of putrefied horribleness. So that's good. Like, I don't know, I just refuse to believe that someone... Just a minute, my brother's walked in when I'm fucking recording and on camera.
Howdy.
Get out my fucking room, there's a reason there's a sign there, you asshole.
Hi!
He's the one who got me the sign! And yet he's the worst one for this shit. It's not even a stupid sister. Like, it's my, like, relatively intelligent brother. I think it's just because he's a prick. Ah, dear. Right, I actually don't know what I'm fighting. I know they're the Empire, but... Okay, so that's... Oh, god damn it, those are pistoliers. That's going to be a problem. And, yep, further pistoliers. No, wait, those are mine. Those are my guys, that's fine.
Let's rush you guys in here. Get the Chaos Cannon firing over there. Let's send our Warhounds after the Pistoliers. And... you know what? Yeah, I'm just going to charge them.
So, I have a question about these games.
Yes?
How far could a person get without, like, a knowledge of tactics, and they just try to brute force everything?
Depends which game it is. You know, it depends which entry in the series it is. In the more recent ones, not very far. Because previously you used to just be able to, like, find things that fuck with the enemy, or just basically, like, rely on the on a not particularly aggressive campaign AI to just kind of sit, just sit there and just let you kill them, really. But you can't get away with it. But, like, the AI isn't that passive anymore. Like, the AI is actually pretty aggressive now.
Those fucking survival instincts.
For God's sake. Your cavalry! Act like it! Ride!
What if they just don't feel like it right now? You have no right to force them to do something they don't want to do.
Like, Sis, would you fight alongside these fucking things? These hideous, ugly, pulsating fucking things.
Well, it depends on how good the pay is.
You don't get paid.
Yeah, then I would not.
It's a matter of basically you fight alongside them or you get killed.
All hail chaos.
I wouldn't trust them to not fucking eat me. You know what I mean?
Yes.
I mean, some of them literally just have giant mouths instead of torsos. Also, I'm worried about just how, like, pretty fucking easily we're clearing out the enemy in this game. You know, almost no real difficulty in killing our enemies. It's a bit... I'm starting to worry, because, like, Chaos is supposed to be pretty overpowered. You know, in everyone else's campaign. Because when chaos happens, it's like Storm of Chaos, and it's like an apocalypse level event. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So the world's supposed to be like basically hanging on by its fingernails at that point.
Hmm.
So I wonder. I wonder if because of that, it's left them really overpowered in their own campaign as well. And good, the dogs are still chasing after these Pistoliers.
Well, at least they're doing something.
I still think it's weird that these dogs don't have handlers. That there's literally, basically, we've just kind of made a deal with packs of wild dogs. You know what I mean?
No, I don't. I don't know anything you mean.
You're an idiot, type, and I hate you.
Good.
Alright, well, I'm getting sick of Type's bullshit, so I think I'm gonna call this stream to an end here. Because I don't think in a single, like, sitting we're actually gonna get that far. You know what I mean? Or rather in, like, a single, like, hour-long thing, we're not gonna get that far, so I don't think I'm gonna be able to show you anything else. So let me just quickly give you some general thoughts on... this here, you know, Total War Warhammer. It's great. Like, it's a really good release. I think Creative Assembly really tried to kind of pull out all the stops for this, given the kind of dodgy launches they had of, Attila and Rome. Attila to a lesser degree, but Rome was, absurdly bad, when it originally came out. And they seem to have, you know, gone out of their way to try and make sure that Total War Warhammer comes off well, and it really has. I've really been enjoying it. Although I must say, if you're gonna play this, you need the mod that sort of that turns off the weird regional occupation rules. Because
do those rules exist in any of the other games?
No.
I wonder why they put it in here.
They said law reasons, but that doesn't make much sense. Because, like... Okay. It's not likely that the humans would go to war with the dwarves. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because they've been allied for ages. But the orcs go to war with the dwarves all the time, and there's a pretty solid chance that the humans would go to war with the dwarves. And if, say, the orcs have been winning against the dwarves, there's a fairly good chance that, like, there's going to be, like, a dwarven karak, like one of their vast underground fortresses, that's been taken over by orcs. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And I'm pretty sure that the humans, if they got the chance, would clear the orcs out of that thing and just use it, because they're defensive marvels. But
okay.
The game just decided you can't do that. You know what I mean? It's just odd. And there's no reason that... there's no reason that the orcs wouldn't just set up camp in a human city. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you know, they got to put the umis in their place.
Umis? It's umis! It's you, not ew.
Umis! You fucking...
Humis, umis, potato, potato... Vase.
I've gone blind in one eye.
Good, the other eye. You're completely blind now.
And it's from sheer...
My rage. My work is done.
Right, but yeah, no. Total War Warhammer's great. I was worried I was going to be disappointed, but I'm really not. I've been fucking loving it. You'll probably see more stuff about Total War Warhammer in the future, and yes, I'm going to be talking about this shit constantly in this week's podcast. So... Yeah, that's...
Bring a book.
How dare you. That's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble nerd, Sideways Thinker, and with me here today has been...
Type in... Thinker.
Say your proper fucking name, asshole.
Type in key.
Good. Goodbye.
Bye.